So let's look at a demo. In this demo, we'll go through the entire process of setting up Ansible and downloading and deploying the NetApp Ansible modules. And then we'll use one of those modules and create a playbook. Okay, so let's get started. The first step is to install the EPEL package. The EPEL package contains the pip package, which is required for installing both Ansible as well as the modules. Now we will install the Python pip using yum install. So after the installation is complete, we follow this with the pip install of Ansible. So once the Ansible pip install is complete, now we can go ahead and add the NetApp lib and SolidFire SDK Python modules. So this allows us to make use of Ansible, and Ansible can start leveraging these modules for automation. Okay. For documentation, you can refer to the Ansible documentation page under storage modules. Navigate to the NetApp section. Look at the modules available for NetApp. Right? Under Ansible, NetApp has a lot of modules which can be leveraged. So the module which we will use for today's demo is the NetApp volume auto size. To view the documentation for this module, once you click on this module, you have the documentation for this particular module. So you can go through the synopsis, what are the requirements to understand the dependencies, and then we have a detailed listing of the parameter and an explanation for each of those parameters. The parameter which is of importance to us is the use REST parameter. So if you would like to leverage REST API, this is the parameter which you turn on, the use REST. We also have an example. We can also leverage this example. Okay. So now let's go back. Let's go back to our instance. And then let's create an Ansible playbook here. So this playbook will actually create a volume. So this is the volume that will be created. And then it will modify the volume auto size parameter. So we will use the host name, the username parameters as variables. And we will kind of change the growth threshold percentage of this volume. It's currently at 99%. We will change it. Okay. So let's run this playbook using the Ansible playbook command. The Ansible playbook will start running. It will gather all the facts, and then it will start with the volume creation, followed by modifying the volume auto size, the auto grow parameter.